It shouldn't come as a surprise that Microsoft Surface Laptop Studio 2 is faster than the previous model. New hardware brings higher performance, and that's exactly what Microsoft's latest offers. The bigger question, and the one I want to focus on during the course of this review, is if the laptop is truly better than the original Surface Laptop Studio. That's a surprisingly important question, not only because Microsoft kept a lot of the elements of the laptop the same, but also because it's charging a much higher price. The Surface Laptop Studio 2 is $400 more expensive than the previous model for its base configuration, clocking in at a clean $2,000. And to get a model with a discrete graphics card, which you'd get for $2,100 previously, you now need to spend $2,400. On top of that, you'll pay upwards of $3,700 if you want the RTX 4060 in the machine, the most powerful GPU Microsoft offers in the laptop. I'll go ahead and tell you up front that Microsoft has addressed the few pain points of the original Surface Laptop Studio, but they don't add up to a machine that is remarkably better than the original model. Sure, there are advancements in the display, port selection, and overall performance, but they're outweighed by the high pricing and some unfortunate regressions in battery life. But hey, before getting into the rest of the review, make sure to leave a like on this video and get subscribed. Thank you very much. Although there are a handful of small updates here, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 is mostly a spec update. Intel's 13th gen Raptor Lake processors and NVIDIA's RTX 40 series Ada Lovelace GPUs take center stage, along with bumps to RAM and storage. Configurations still start at 16 gigabytes of RAM, but you can now reach up to 64 gigabytes. And although the Surface Laptop Studio 2 tops out at 2 terabytes of storage, just like the previous model, the base model delivers 512 gigabytes, up from the 256 gigabytes seen previously. The bump in RAM is a little problematic though. More is better if you need it, but it's how Microsoft splits up its configurations that makes the 64 gigabytes of RAM such a hassle. In order to get a Surface Laptop Studio 2 with an RTX 4060, you need to buy a configuration with at least 1 terabyte of storage and 64 gigabytes of RAM. That means you're paying at least $3,300 and as much as $3,700, even if you don't need all of that RAM or storage. Frankly, it doesn't make any sense. There's a good argument you need an RTX 4060, but don't need 64 gigabytes of RAM. Similarly, 1 terabyte or 2 terabytes of storage is great out of the gate, but you can replace the SSD in the Surface Laptop Studio 2. Microsoft doesn't even offer the option to reduce the price if you want to upgrade the storage on your own. Interestingly, the sole configuration with NVIDIA's RTX 2000 Ada, a workstation class GPU, comes with only 32 gigabytes of storage and a 1 terabyte SSD, despite being $3,600. Something is seriously off with the pricing of these higher-end configurations. Lower down the stack, pricing is a little more sensible, with $2,000 being the base price. For that, you'll get 16 gigabytes of RAM, 512 gigabytes of storage, and integrated graphics. You'll need to spend an extra $400 if you want NVIDIA RTX 4050, and another $400 on top of that if you want 32 gigabytes of RAM and a 1 terabyte SSD. That's still $200 cheaper, however, than upgrading the 14-inch MacBook Pro M2 Pro with a 1 terabyte SSD and 32 gigabytes of RAM, so it's not all bad. Pricing isn't too out of sorts compared to the 14-inch MacBook Pro, with the Surface Laptop Studio 2 arriving slightly cheaper depending on your configuration. However, it's much higher than competing Windows laptops like the Dell XPS 15. For the same price as the cheapest RTX 4060 configuration of the Surface Laptop Studio 2, you can get the XPS 15 with an Intel Core i9-13900H, RTX 4070, 64 GB of memory, 2 TB of storage, and a 3.5K OLED touch display. Just goes to show how expensive the Surface Laptop Studio 2 and the MacBook Pro, for that matter, really are. But the Surface Laptop Studio and the MacBook Pro have something in common that other Windows laptops really can't touch. There's a perfect marriage of hardware and software here that I like to call the Surface Advantage. That's true of all Surface devices, but it's worth highlighting on the Laptop Studio 2. Windows Hello 2.0 signs you in before you can blink, the touchpad never misreads gestures, Windows Studio Effects look fantastic with the ultra-sharp webcam, and the new Adaptive Touch feature, which allows you to use basically any Surface as an input, really does deliver on what Microsoft is calling the most inclusive trackpad ever. There's just this premium experience to using the Surface Laptop Studio 2 that others' Windows machines just can't match, no matter how much more powerful or how much cheaper they are. For instance, the rounded corners of Windows 11 are matched perfectly with the rounded corners of the PixelSense Flow display. It just feels like you're using a premium laptop no matter what you're doing. The Surface Laptop Studio 2's signature modularity stands out here too. Just like the previous model, you have Stage Mode where you can pull the display towards you, and Studio Mode where the display lays flat on the keyboard. Like before, the metal hinge and magnets that hold the system together feel robust, but the Surface Laptop Studio 2 enjoins the enhanced tablet mode now in Windows 11. Within a second of pulling the screen forward, Windows 11 adapts to its tablet mode that enlarges icons and pulls the taskbar down. To be clear, this is a software improvement that's available in other convertible laptops, but it feels right on the Surface Laptop Studio 2. It's that Surface advantage, bringing together Windows with hardware in a way other devices really can't manage. Still, there isn't anything new here. I love Stage Mode for watching movies and playing games, and using the Surface Slim Pen 2 in Studio Mode is great, especially considering you can attach it magnetically under the front lip of the device. However, you can get that same functionality on the much cheaper original model. The entire outer shell looks identical, despite being a little thicker overall. The Surface Laptop Studio 2 adds a tenth of an inch to the thickness of the previous model, as well as nearly half a pound. It ends up just shy of a full pound heavier than the MacBook Pro 14, as well as 0.2 inches thicker. Now, one of the big talking points for the Surface Laptop Studio 2 has been the improved PixelSense Flow display. It's less of an improvement than Microsoft is making it out to be, though. You're getting the same specs as the original Laptop Studio overall. It's a 14.4 inch display with a 3:2 aspect ratio and a resolution of 2400 by 1600. That comes out to 200 pixels per inch, which is less than the 254 offered by the 14 inch MacBook Pro and the 262 available on the Dell XPS 15's 3.5K OLED display. Still, the screen looks very sharp given the size. It's not the best based on pure pixel density, but that hardly matters at this size and resolution. As before, you get access to a 120Hz refresh rate, which is a fair trade-off given the lower pixel density. I'd take a smooth desktop and gaming experience any day, which isn't offered on the 60Hz OLED display available on the XPS 15. The MacBook Pro claims 120Hz, but that's only available through Apple's ProMotion smoothing. The Surface Laptop Studio 2 definitely has the edge here, as did the previous model. Those specs are all the same, but Microsoft made improvements to the brightness in HDR. The screen is now certified with VESA's Display HDR 400, mostly due to higher peak brightness. I measured 531 nits of peak brightness and a contrast ratio of 650 to 1, which is great. Still, it falls short of the Lenovo Slim Pro 9i with its mini LED display and, of course, OLED displays available on machines from Asus and Dell. Regardless, the display looks stunning, due in no small part to its glossy finish that seems well equipped to keep fingerprints at bay. My main issue is color coverage. My testing produced only 77% of the DCI-P3 extended color space, which is less than the original Surface Laptop Studio's 82%. The screen still covers 100% of sRGB and was very color accurate with less than one color error on average, but I don't like seeing a regression in color coverage. Along with bumping the brightness, Microsoft has added two new ports on the Surface Laptop Studio 2, a USB-A 3.1 port and a micro SD card slot. I know. Hold your applause. They join the two USB-C ports with Thunderbolt 4, along with the 3.5mm headphone jack. It's been very interesting to see these supposed MacBook killers double back on USB-A after a little time in the sun, but that's a different conversation. I'm happy with the addition, though the ports feel very stiff. I had an external hard drive get stuck in the USB-A port several times before it finally smoothed out. It wasn't just kind of stuck either. I was worried I was going to break the port trying to get it unplugged. Similarly, the stiff microSD card slot made me wonder if I was inserting the card the right way. I mean, these problems went away after using the ports a dozen times or more, but the ports still feel oddly stiff. On top of the machine, you're getting the same keyboard, but an updated trackpad. As mentioned, Microsoft says the Surface Laptop Studio 2 has the most inclusive trackpad ever, and that's largely due to the adaptive touch feature. It disables gestures, but it's a huge step for accessibility on laptops. Not much has changed otherwise, though. The keyboard is still excellent with its 1.3 millimeters of key travel, and the haptic touchpad is responsive with four different levels of haptic feedback. Not much has changed here, but Microsoft really didn't need to change anything. The keyboard and trackpad are great, and I'm glad Microsoft didn't mess with them. In addition, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 packs the same 1080p webcam as the previous model, but it's bolstered this time by Windows Studio Effects. The webcam looks fantastic, offering great color in brightly lit areas and avoiding grain in low light conditions. Really though, Windows Studio Effects are what's important here. For the first time, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 comes with Intel's Gen 3 Movidius 3700 VC AI Accelerator. Currently, that's used in Windows Studio Effects to offer auto framing, eye contact, and background blur features, all of which look excellent when accelerated by AI. That's just about the only purpose for this chip right now, though. We could see, and probably will see, more in the future, but the AI Accelerator really isn't a reason to buy the Surface Laptop Studio 2 right now. After all, the machine includes an NVIDIA GPU that has access to NVIDIA Broadcast, which offers similar effects that are accelerated by AI. All right, on to the big difference with the Surface Laptop Studio 2, performance. Starting with the default recommended power mode, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 gets destroyed by similarly configured machines. The Dell XPS 15 is clearly ahead with the same processor and Cinebench, both for single core and multi-core performance, and the M2 Max MacBook Pro 14 is even faster. That single core result in Cinebench isn't a typo either. I reran that test 4 times and got the same result. The same was true in Handbrake, with the XPS 15 completed the transcode more than 20 seconds faster than the Surface Laptop Studio 2, as did the M2 Max. Strangely, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 managed to beat the XPS 15 in Premiere Pro despite sporting a weaker GPU, though it still fell much short of the MacBook Pro 14 with the M2 Max. Little strange, but the power modes of the Surface Laptop Studio 2 have a massive impact on performance. Switching to the best performance mode, you can see the Surface Laptop Studio 2 match the single core and multi-core performance of the XPS 15 and Cinebench. Similarly, it falls short of the MacBook Pro's massive core array in the multi-core test, but it takes a clear lead in the single core test, beating everything but the MSI Prestige 16. Handbrake was much better too, with the XPS 15 and Surface Laptop Studio 2 evenly matched, and the MacBook Pro 14 actually taking a slight back seat. The Lenovo Slim Pro 7 with the Ryzen 7 7735HS is behind here as well. Unfortunately, the same isn't true in Premiere Pro, where I actually saw a slight regression in the best performance mode. In this app, the MacBook Pro 14 still wins the day by a significant margin, regardless of the Windows laptop you compare it to. It's clear that any serious work should be done with the best performance power profile. The machine runs hotter and gets louder, but never to the point of being uncomfortable. I'm just shocked Microsoft dialed back the performance so much with the recommended profile. Even with this performance, the Core i7-13700H is in an awkward spot in the Surface Laptop Studio 2. It's arriving a couple of months before Intel will start shipping its 14th gen Meteor Lake processors, which come with an AI accelerator built in. I'm not sure why Microsoft didn't just wait a couple of months. The Core i7-13700H inside the Surface Laptop Studio 2 performs well, but it will almost certainly be outclassed by newer Windows laptops in just a handful of weeks. Not a promising sign for a machine that you could easily spend over $3,000 on. Moving on to graphics performance though, I ran 3D Mark TimeSpy and FireStrike to get a general sense of gaming performance. This isn't a gaming laptop, but it certainly can run games thanks to a discrete NVIDIA GPU and access to features like Deep Learning Super Sampling 3. In the recommended profile, the Surface Laptop Studio 2 beats everything except the Alienware X14 R2, which is the only dedicated gaming laptop here. It's even beating the XPS 15, which has a faster GPU on paper. What's really interesting is when you look at the performance in the best performance power mode, where the Surface Laptop Studio 2 even bests the Alienware X14 R2, both in TimeSpy and FireStrike. All of this performance comes with a cost though, battery life. Frankly, Microsoft's claims of up to 18 hours of battery life with the Surface Laptop Studio 2 are egregious. It doesn't get anywhere close. In our web browsing test, the laptop lasted just under 7.5 hours, and in our 1080p local video playback test, it fell just short of 10 hours. Microsoft says you can get up to 18 hours with typical device usage, but if browsing the internet and playing videos isn't typical, I'm really not sure what is. It's almost identical to the Alienware X14 R2, which has a similar configuration. That's a gaming laptop though. For a more fair battle, the XPS 15 lasted almost 2 hours longer in our web browsing test and almost 3 hours longer in video playback. It's an absolute bloodbath when you bring in the 14-inch MacBook Pro, which lasted nearly 20 hours with the M2 Max. I didn't expect 18 hours of battery life out of the Surface Laptop Studio 2. I know what the components inside are capable of. What's really disappointing here is that the original Surface Laptop Studio lasted longer. It offered 10 and a half hours in our web browsing test and as much as 12 hours with local video playback. Microsoft majorly dropped the ball here. It's very hard judging the Surface Laptop Studio 2 because so much of it has stayed the same, and for everything Microsoft has improved, there are areas where the Laptop Studio 2 is oddly worse. There are some improvements over the original model, but for those who don't need peak power and just want a top shelf laptop are better off buying the previous version. It's cheaper at list price, and Microsoft is offering upwards of $500 off on configurations that are still available. Obviously, performance is a big reason to upgrade for some people. For similar Windows laptops like the XPS 15, you're getting similar performance to the Surface Laptop Studio 2 for a significantly higher price. For the same price, you can get the MacBook Pro 14 with the M2 Max, all while getting similar and sometimes better performance and much better battery life. There is a particular audience that will love the Surface Laptop Studio 2, those that demand peak performance and want the unique form factor the machine offers. Most people are fine saving some money with a similarly premium Windows machine or jumping to the MacBook Pro though, and both situations show clear advantages over the Surface Laptop Studio 2. But what do you think? Are you willing to overlook the problems of the Surface Laptop Studio 2 for its unique form factor? Let me know in the comments below. While you're down there, make sure to leave a like on this video and get subscribed. All right, everyone, thanks for watching. I will see you in the next video.